Hey, ladies and gentlemen, this is Carmine Sabia for Explain America, and Kamala Harris has just made a big mistake, according to some, that could cost her the entire campaign. Before we get started, please make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. Those little things really help us out, and they help our channel continue to grow. And if you're not watching us on YouTube, guys, it really assists us and helps us spread the conservative message if you do that. The address is right there in the lower right-hand corner. It's youtube.com/@explainamerica. Just go there and hit subscribe for free, and you're doing your part to help make America great again. Guys, Kamala Harris's honeymoon with the polls and with the people and the media propping her up, it could have only lasted so long. The polls are starting to show she's declining to Biden levels. Trump is rising again in the important swing state polls. She's going to have a bump next week at the DNC. Don't freak out about it. Because what happened this week is notable. It's so notable that even people on the left are starting to point it out. Her big mistake was showing her hand. It was showing people exactly who she is. And this is in a scripted press conference. Imagine if she has to actually answer questions or have a press conference with reporters. This was scripted. And what did she show? In my opinion, in the opinion of a lot of people, she's an out-and-out downright communist. And we have video footage of her from 2020, the 2020 campaign. This is probably more of 2019, but the 2020 campaign, where she's talking about snatching the patents from private companies. Basically, the government taking control of businesses. Gosh, that sounds a lot like Karl Marx. And then, just this week, she talks about price fixing. That sounds a lot like Venezuela. Doesn't work. Has never worked. Sounds great when you tell the people. And they're like, yeah, get those rich guys. Class warfare works because the majority of people are poor or middle class. And so get the rich guys is a heck of a slogan if you want to get a populist movement behind you. You know, eat the rich, that whole thing. But they're going to be eating nothing. They're going to be eating nothing but stale, crusty bread if they go along with this insane scheme. And her showing her cards, that, as this one reporter said, that might have been her biggest mistake. Let's take a look and then leave your comments. Let me know what you think in the comments section.
And now she puts out a plan that says she's a communist. So at least we can have an honest debate about two different ideas.
Yeah, it's a big mistake for her. It may be honest, but she had to come out and make the mistake at some point. At some point, you have to come out and put a little meat on the bone. Okay, who am I? What do I actually believe? Is it different than Joe Biden? So she started with the economy because that's the biggest issue.
Right.
But then she led with her commie foot forward of like, okay, we're going to do caps and controls and giveaways. Mm-hmm. Whoa. Okay, that has been tried before, and it has devastated economies. Our own economy in the 70s. The Latin America, same thing.
Argentina, so Venezuela. This is,
the more she has to put meat on the bone and actually talk and answer questions and reveal who she is, that's her problem. That's why they kept her in the bubble so long. That's why they'll keep her in the bubble as long as they can. Because this is her core of what she believes. Ouch. There's no free market ideas in what she revealed.
Nothing.
Not at all.
She stole a few ideas from Trump, but...
Well, the no tax on tips is just a steal. That's it.
It is interesting, and I think Greg Gutfeld pointed this out yesterday on The Five. For her to be accused of socialism or communism is a tool that is only so sharp. It's a knife that can be dulled, because that has quite honestly been wielded often by the right. And it's even dulled when you hear it in her own words, because she basically admits to it. You have to listen, because it's put in philosophical terms where she's like, I believe in equal outcomes. I could play you a montage where she said that on numerous occasions. But now you're seeing the actual mechanics of communism. And it's less Soviet and more Venezuelan. Because to your point, Pete, it's accompanied by the handout. It's got a sheen of populism over it.
Mm-hmm.
I'll give you 25 grand to buy a house. I will control prices to help your groceries. That is the kind of stuff that has appealed to people across Latin America for years and has played out with tragic consequences on their economies.
Yep.
Absolutely. Go ahead.
No. I was just going to say she's very neighborly. That's what
Yes, that's very neighborly. She's going to take your neighbor's stuff and give it to somebody else.
Tim Walz thing.
Yeah, in the name of equity. Well, Stephen Moore, we had him on last week. He gave me an A.